Hi, love bugs. Welcome back. So this is basically part two to my life update. And I'm going to be talking about my post-op surgery. So if you didn't catch the first video, sorry. I went had to have surgery for my fibroids, also a hysterectomy along with that. So that's what we're talking about today. I had a major episode in the middle part of the year with the lost pregnancy due to fibroids and having to spend a 12-day stint in the hospital and recovering and all of that because of these little creatures that were in me. Yeah, so we're gonna talk about that, my experience. How was it? Well, I'm here. I guess that's the greatest thing, thank God. But yeah, the surgery went very well. I mean, it happened quickly. I thought I would be terribly frightened that morning. I had to be there at 6 a.m. I just want to talk about what to expect if you are going to have this sort of procedure done. A hysterectomy due to fibroids, that is. I woke up. I was supposed to get up at a certain time. I was like, ah, screw it. I'm gonna get up. I'm just gonna just get dressed. And I was like, hey, I'm ready, guys. My mom and my boyfriend, they took me. I arrived like 15, 20 minutes early and checked in. Got the little band on my arm, which made it official. That's when, my nerves kind of kicked in because the ball just immediately started to roll, You had to go into a room and change into your gown, and before I knew it, the nurses were coming in and they were questioning me, and then the anesthesiologist came in, and everyone was in the room giggling and laughing, and before you knew it, I was like, ha 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 ha, lights out. It happened so quickly, and my eyes closed to women laughing, and woke up to men in green chatting it up and laughing as well. So it just seemed like it was just like a split second. It happened just that quickly. All right, so when you're having this sort of procedure done, which is major surgery, it's considered to be major. All right. You have to go in with the mindset that you're not going to change completely, but your body, you won't be the same afterwards. Okay? Let's just keep it real. And by when doing this, I recommend doing it with a surgeon who is very well experienced. I actually had just became a patient with this my gynecologist who actually did my surgery. And for the pre-op, he actually gave me a rundown of everything, his qualifications, over 1,000 surgeries. He had like maybe 4 or 5 mishaps. Nothing too serious, or something you could just stitch up and go about. So you want your doctor to be able to voice this and tell you this, because when you're in this sort of state of mind, you may not come up with the questions then, but to gain as much knowledge as you can about the doctor and also what hospital you're going to have it at, that really matters. Okay. I mean, the hospital I went to wasn't the best. It wasn't like the first hospital I was in. But you want your experience to be one that is a very good, pleasant experience because of what you're about to go through. All right. So afterwards, everyone was so nice and cordial, and you want that. I didn't have a lot of guests, my mom, my sister, my boyfriend. It's pretty much it. Because you're going to be tired, you're going to be exhausted, you're going to need that peace. And you want even the staff to be one that is friendly. Because when you're in that great deal of pain, you don't need anyone with an attitude, okay? I mean, my nurses were so cool. They came in and watched Wendy Williams with me, had coffee with me. Shh, don't tell anyone. But yeah, that's the type of experience that you want. You want the entire process to be that of peace and calmness, okay? Because when you leave that hospital, you're not gonna have while you're in the hospital, you have like, your little machine where you can just press the button every 5 minutes and it releases morphine to ease the pain. You're not going to have that. You're not going to have people bidding for you. So you want to be able to have everything set up for you. Like I had like a bedside table with my water, my beverages, my little snacks, tissues, everything, a little heater, a little space heater, because I lost a lot of blood, which made me anemic. So you just want to have everything. They're not going to tell you this, unless of course you have like a little person who doesn't mind doing the bidding for you and not going to whine and pout about it. Whatever. Okay, but everyone, had to get back to work, so you're kind of like on your own, and you want to be set up in that way, and the pain is like the worst for me. Anyway, I even have a high tolerance and a strong threshold for pain, but it is like, yeah, it's serious. I mean, they're not gonna tell you that. It's gonna be like pulling your eyes out when you sneeze and cough. Even now, sitting up out of bed, because you have to use your midsection to sit up. Luckily, my guy went and got me a cane so I can have leverage to pull myself up out of bed. Because you may be a little too weak to do that on your own. And it is like sitting down. I mean, it's very bad. I'm not trying to scare you. I'm just, hey, I don't sugarcoat anything. So it's been 3 weeks now. Yeah. And I had the little strips moved from the incision. I didn't know that you're also stitched on the inside, which would explain this discomfort I have. I'm still having difficulty walking, and the anesthesia, let me tell you, that anesthesia is no joke. They say it wears off in a couple days. I don't believe that. I even Googled it. It stays with you. Your cognitive behavior may be a little off. I've been so clumsy lately, like you won't believe what I dropped yesterday. But yeah, so you're off balance. Your focus is off. I have bouts of just wooziness and lethargic, lethargic, to where you just want to just lie down and go sleep. Like right now, when I finish this video, I'm going to go and lie down. So, but the feat is that you have to walk. Your doctors are going to tell you to move. I mean, like the next day you get out, you have to move because you don't want to clot. And you want your bowels and everything. You want your bowels to, let me tell you. Also purchase stool softener, please, because especially with the medication you're gonna have in your system, it's gonna make you bloated and you're not gonna do anything. And it's painful on top of whatever else you're feeling. All right. So you're going to have to move, and it hurts. Okay. So it's like, sorry, you have to do this, but yeah, it sucks. And that's pretty much it. Is you'll get a pattern of what it is that you should do each day, and go by how your body feels. If you want to shower every day, you can. That's fine. If not, just make sure you wipe off, and they give you bacterial wipes and all that too, just in case. But I showered every day because I wanted to. And you can eat whatever you want, but I just recommend eating healthier foods that aid your digestion, like corn maybe or something. But other than that, it's one heck of an experience, I can tell you that. I miss my girl parts. Even my mother nature, she still tried to come, and you'll have signs of that. Mother nature. But other than that, it's okay. It's a good surgery. The pain sucks, but it makes you stronger, I guess. And I highly recommend you really thinking about this procedure. See, I had this had fibroids since I was 25, so I was long overdue. I mean, you can do whatever it is that you want to do to try to prevent this type of surgery. They have like little things. I did all of that. Using the progesterone cream, teas, all. You can do that for as long as you can, but when you start having elongated periods that are far worse than they used to be, and uterine bleeding, problems with digestion, that's when it's time. That's when it's getting big. And it also stretches your uterine. My uterus was, not to be too graphic, sorry guys, But my uterus is like 9 times the size of a normal uterus. So imagine me carrying like 12 fibroids the size of plums and baseballs along with that. That's a lot. I had a lot going on, a lot. I didn't know it, but it was a lot. And that's that. That's pretty much it. Just be certain that you want to have this procedure. You can't have children any longer if you do. That's another thing to think about. You know, factoring your age. It's actually, I think, it's pretty critical if you try to have a baby. If you have like enlarged fibroids, you don't want to jeopardize yourself. Okay, that happened to me. So we don't, I lost my child. So we don't want that. So yeah, just think about it and have faith that you're going to come out and that's it. All right. If you have any questions, link it down below. I'm here for you guys. I thank you so much for your well wishes and your support. I love you. I love you. I love you. And until next time, my loves, take care.